Good morning, students. Welcome to the English class. We are going to start an lesson, a hero, ek nayak. Today we'll only read out the text. Aaj hum log keval text ko padhenge. Tomorrow we will learn the meaning of adverbs. After that we will solve the exercises and question answers. कल हम लोग जो है इसकी वर्ड मीनिंग को पढ़ेंगे और उसके बाद क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट रीडिंग द टेस्ट. अ हीरो. स्वामी इज ए 9 year ओल्ड बॉय हु लिव्स इन मालगुड़ी विलेज विद हिज पेरेंट्स एंड ग्रैंड मदर. वन डे हिज फादर वॉज रीडिंग अ न्यूज पेपर. स्वामी लिसन टू दिस अ न्यूज ऑफ the bravery of a village lad who, while returning home by the jungle path, came face to face with a tiger till some people came that way and killed the tiger. After reading it through, father looked at Swami and asked, "What do you say to that, Swami?" "I think he must have been a very strong and grown-up person, not at all a boy. How could a boy fight a tiger?" "Father, a man may have the strength of an elephant and yet be coward, whereas another man who may have the strength of a straw but has courage can do anything." "Swami, suppose I have all the courage, what can I do if a tiger attacks me?" "Father, let alone strength can you prove you have a courage. You have courage. Let me see if you can sleep alone tonight in my office." Swami had always slept beside his granny, which irritated his father. "Swami, from the first of the next month I will sleep alone, father." "Father, no, you must do it from today." In the evening, Swami went to his granny and slept under her blanket. His father came and said to him, "Father, get up." "Granny, why do you disturb him?" Father rolled his bed and took it under his arms. "Father, come with me." "Swami, let me sleep in the hall, please. Your office is very dusty and there may be scorpions behind your law books." "Father, no. You must learn not to be afraid of darkness. It is only a question of habit. You must cultivate good habits." As the night advanced and the silence in the house deepened, Swami's heart beat faster. He remembered all the stories of the devils and ghosts he had heard in his life. He shut his eyes tight and covered himself with his blanket under the bench. He put his hand out to feel Granny's presence at his side, as it was his habit, but he only touched the wooden leg of the bench. He sweated with fright. Swami moved to the edge of the bench. He stared into the darkness. Something was moving down. As it came nearer, thinking it is a ghost, he crawled out from under the bench and hugged it with all his might. He used his teeth on it like a weapon. The creature yelled out in pain. In a moment, his father, the cook, and a servant came in carrying a light. All the three fell on the burglar, who lay amidst furniture with a bleeding ankle. Father called the police. The police were grateful to Swami as he had caught the notorious thief. The next day in the school, Swami's classmates congratulated him and looked at him with respect. The headmaster said that Swami was a true scout. The news of his bravery was also published in Malgudi Days. This story has been adapted from Malgudi Days by R.K. Narayanan. Okay, students, today we'll read out only the text. we will learn the meaning of hard words tomorrow. Thank you, all the best.